I was really ready for this project. I had really wanted to make a record that was based on, you know, songwriting, but with like this cool psychedelic rock aesthetic. I would say that the first guitar stuff that I learned was Jimmy Page, Jimi Hendrix. So that was really what inspired me to play music. So I kind of like took this left turn at one point and started playing more funk and soul music, but now I wanted to really combine that with like the roots of what where I came from. So I called up Ryan Zoidis, told him I was working on a new project, told him what the vibe was, and he was like, you have to call Dave. You have to call Dave Gutter. You know, as soon as he said that, I was like, yes. Because I was looking for someone to write with that could really help flesh out these ideas.
I hadn't ever given my songs that I write to anybody else. I'd never written for anybody else. It had only been a thing that was like personal to me. I was really excited to do it because Kras has always been very expressive in his playing. So, you know, you have all these instrumentals and all this music that is just bursting with character and nuance and personality. And even without the lyrics, there's a mood that is set.
So I packed up my car with a bunch of microphones and some amps and some guitars, and I was like, okay, I'm going to Maine. We're gonna see what happens. You know, I just had like some voice memos on my phone of like some ideas.
And at first when he called me to do the record, it was just gonna be pre-production. Like we were gonna flush out some of his ideas.
Really thought we were gonna make demos because it was a pretty raw space and without a lot of gear. But as we got together and started playing through some of the tracks, we realized there was some magic happening.
We have a very basic setup. We have this analog board over here. We have this tape machine, which isn't good enough to really record a record.
We knew that we wanted to create an analog sound with this record. We borrowed an old tape machine, used like a dusty old console and a bunch of cables. Next thing you know, all these musicians in Maine were bringing gear or letting us borrow microphones and amplifiers. It really got around town that we were working on this project, and next thing you know, there was like singers coming by to like help us with background parts, and Dave Noyes from Rustic Overtones came and did a string arrangement. We recorded strings and we had horns, and so what had initially been let's demo and write a couple songs and record some demos became we're making an album.
Here's the studio, control room.
We had to utilize some unorthodox areas of the studio for isolation. We did everything live.
This is one of the favorite reverbs on the record, this old stereo. It's made for a stereo, spring reverb.
It was like a vintage instrument haven here.
So Kras's amp was set up next to this Honda, 1977 Honda, for the whole session.
Many different techniques were used to create unique reverbs and delays for the record.
I had been hanging out with the London Souls guys a bunch, so I knew that Chris would just be great for this record and for these ideas that I started working on.
We were coming up with musical arrangements sometimes before the melodies were even completed, while lyrics were being written in another room.
The other thing is that we weren't on the clock in an expensive studio. We were in an old barn, and the creative energy was like through the roof because we were all just like really excited on the ideas that were coming together.
He had a vision for what he wanted the songs to sound like and the style of them, but he wasn't sure if he was going to be singing them.
And I've always really been into songwriters and singers, you know, even though I didn't always sing with my projects, I was always writing songs and working with other singers. So to be able to come out and be the singer myself was a new idea, but it had been brewing for a long time.
But once we heard him sing a couple of the tunes, like we were like, dude, you have to sing these.
We didn't want to make the only blues record to ever be made without whiskey. So, you know, sometimes we'd get the whiskey, that little extra grit and confidence in the late night vocal sessions.
What I realized, I guess, was that it made sense for me to sing these. And this was going to be, even though it was really a collective effort to make the record, that the process was really finding my voice and finding the songs that made sense for me to sing. So I worked on tracks for the next like 2 years after that session, and that's where I brought Jeremy Most in to co-produce, because he really helped me hone it into one piece. So he kind of added a lot of elements, samples and keys and background vocals. And the experimentation is really what kind of fueled this record and kind of fueled the songwriting.